Hello, America. During the election 2008, some people were questioning whether or not Barack Obama were a socialist. There was some strong evidence, his past association, and his own words. Well, then he was elected, and immediately Newsweek celebrated with this title. I remember holding that up on TV and saying, "We are?" Then the president started to govern. And the more he governed, the more he, quacked like a duck, walked like a duck. And so people started pointing that out. And the more I got into it, the more I saw this network that he had cobbled together, that had been cobbled together, and he was brought in. We've shown you their words, not my words, their words. You've seen the policies, and all the president's friends just happen to be anti-free market Marxists. And it is being completely dismissed and overlooked intentionally by the media today. The Communist Party USA is involved with the left's big counter 828 rally. It's called One Nation. What I told you to do last night is go to USA's website, Communist Party USA, and you click on One Nation Working Together. Takes you right to the deal. Now, here are the groups endorsing 10210. This page reads more like an FBI most wanted list. Every single president from George Washington to now has recognized enemies that are within. They have recognized that the communists are a problem. But this president is doing the opposite. Look at some of the 300 plus groups associated with this rally that is supported by Charlie Rangel and Howard Dean and Obama's own group of Organizing for America. They sent out this email. This is Obama's group, Organizing for America, promoting this event. The event organizers were so excited that they posted this on their website. Obama, where is it? Obama Organizing Group pushes liberal march next weekend. The biggest progressive demonstration in decades. So, who's coming? Well, let me show you. Because there's a lot of the usual suspects here, but you really need to know who everybody is. First of all, Green for All. Who is that? That, of course, is our communist revolutionary friend, 9/11 truther, Van Jones. Then there's Sojourners. This is, of course, Jim Wallace, the Marxist preacher for the president. Then you have SCIU, who is the former member of SDS, who is also now under investigation by the FBI for, Andy Stern is under investigation with the FBI for corruption. Then you have, of course, the National Council of La Raza. La Raza, what is La Raza? Translation, the race. Then Color of Change. This is just another one of the communist Van Jones organizations. Van Jones also, before he started this one and got involved in this one, he did Storm. I've asked you to read about Storm. Again, don't take my word for it that the guy's a communist. Read Storm, a group, a communist group, a communist revolutionary group, according to their manual, that says Storm members brought experience in the militant street tactics, revolutionary agitation, and coalition building. Oh, coalition building, like One Nation, working together. Okay. Then you have the National Organization of Women. You also have Code Pink, Women for Peace. Code Pink, remember, this is the group that had ties to the flotilla that eventually attacked Israel, that also has ties to Hamas, and William Ayers and Bernadine Dorn, Weather Underground members that blew things up. Then you have, of course, Planned Parenthood, which was started by racist Margaret Sanger, who just Planned Parenthood, all they were trying to do is just get rid of some of the undesirables through eugenics. There are too many progressive groups to count. There's the Progress Ohio, Progress Congress Action Fund, Progressive Democrats of America, Progressive Democrats of America, New York, and New York City chapter. And then there is the Committee of Correspondence for Democracy and Socialism, the Democratic Socialists of America, the Chicago Democratic Socialists of America, the Detroit Democratic Socialists of America, the New York City Democratic Socialists of America. I mean, it just goes on and on and on. But it is absolutely inconceivable that a reporter asks the president, are you a socialist? Do you know what a democratic socialist is? When the former Soviet Union fell apart, they were given a choice. We can have fundamental change of the Soviet Union, or we can remain communist, and then we'll have a riot in the streets. The communists, like Vladimir Putin, took off his uniform, removed his gun, burned his communist card, and became a democratic socialist. It's communist, without the uniform and the gun. So, look who else. We have the Communist Party USA standing with this rally this weekend. I'd like to say something here. They have the communist as an endorser on their own website. And nobody says a word? But it only gets worse from there. They also have the Peace and Freedom Party. That one's a great organization. Sounds great, Peace and Freedom, who's not for that? But they are the same party that nominated as their presidential candidate this guy in 2004. His name, Leonard Peltier. Peltier kind of had a hard time campaigning at the time because he was in prison for murder. He just slaughtered two FBI agents back in 1975, but who hasn't done that? Then there is International Answer. Do I have International Answers? This International Answer is an anti-war group with close ties to the Workers' World Party. Workers' World Unite, what? Yeah, I've heard that from Andy Stern, and this guy, and this guy, and this guy. Isn't that weird? But the Workers' World Party was a revolutionary Marxist-Leninist party founded in the 1950s, and they're still kicking. They've sought to link the Palestinian clause with the other anti-colonialist and anti-occupation clauses. Anti-colonialist, where have I heard of that? Oh, that's right, anti-colonialist, from Barack Obama, in Dreams From My Father. Not Dreams Of My Father, Dreams From My Father. That's right, because his father was an anti-colonialist, and so is his grandfather. They hated Great Britain, and so does he. Bah, I'm sure it's nothing. Also, International Answer has routinely supported terror groups like Hezbollah and Hamas. These are all groups that they're very, very proud of. Plus, America's Campaign for America's Future is involved. That's a great one. They're focused on progressive transformation, funded by George Soros. But there's also Campus Progress, which is also an offshoot of the Center for American Progress, funded by George Soros. Then there, of course, is the Gray Panthers. They are great. Age and youth in action. People over profits. Remember that slogan, will you? Then we have the Courage Campaign. They're partners with MoveOn.org. They push for full equality and progressive change in California like they need anymore. Then you have the Yaya Network. The Yaya Network, never heard of that one? This is a social justice group active in the counter-military recruitment movement. Here's an ad. The Yaya is now hiring youth organizers, calling all organizers, leaders, rabble-rousers, troublemakers, and rebels with a cause. Must be 15 to 19 year old. Wow. Troublemakers. Troublemakers that are 15 to 19 years old, what could they possibly want with troublemakers between July 2010 through August 2011? What could they possibly be looking for with teenage troublemakers? Giving them jobs when this Congress and this president have made sure that 16 to 24 year olds just can't find a job. Then, of course, there's Solidarity. You know, the one with the red star as the logo. They were quote, founded in 1986 by revolutionary socialists who stand for socialism from below. Socialism from below. Solidarity wants the self-organization of the working class and oppressed peoples. Oppressed peoples, oppressed peoples. Where have I heard that before? Oh, yeah, the Weather Underground. Oh, and Jeremiah Wright, too. Here he is, Jeremiah Wright. Did you know that his church is also a proud sponsor? The United Church of Christ. The National Jobs for All Coalition is also involved in this. They just seek shared prosperity and more leisure time for you. Then, of course, the Humanist Party is involved. They want to give you the right to vote. You know, well, not you, but you if you're a non-citizen, i.e. illegal in New York. Also, the Student Action Labor Project. Student Action Labor. Notice it spells SLAP. Do you think it's a coincidence that it's called SLAP? It's just part of Jobs for Justice. SLAP engages student organizations in economic justice campaigns. Then there is a Campus Camp Wellstone. This is a camp for a labor program customized to meet the needs of individual unions. They partner with progressive labor organizations to help build infrastructure. So basically, you can say that it's a labor camp. And then there's Wishadoo. This looks so nice. Be the missing piece. This has everything to do with mutual benefit, supporting and sustaining the common good, shifting the traditional model of profit-only corporation to mutual benefit cooperation. Yeah. Yeah. Here's a great one. The International Socialist Organization. They say socialism is not only possible, but worth fighting for. The ISO stands in the tradition of revolutionary socialists Karl Marx, V.I. Lenin, and Leon Trotsky in the belief that workers themselves, the vast majority of the population, are the only force that can lead the fight to win a socialist society. Be brought out from above, but has to be won by the workers themselves. I believe these people, when they say violent or when they say revolution, and they talk about Lenin, Trotsky, they mean the fist and force. Now, I'd love to see the president come out and denounce socialism. Marxists, communists, revolutionaries. Once, Mr. President, once deny Marxism, communism, revolutionaries. Tell us you are against all of this. Marxism is evil. And the only thing that it has contributed to in the history of mankind is mass graves. All of these groups and the President of the United States want nothing short of fundamental transformation of America. It is not about cleaning up corruption. It is only a beginning of a radical, revolutionary, Marxist land. Do not allow them to get away with the lies. Do not allow them to say that we are just one nation working together. We're just trying to put America back to work and putting America back together. These people, a lot of them, have fought their entire life to destroy America. Do you remember this from the last campaign?
Yes, we can! Yes, we can! Yes, okay. We can! Yes, we can!
Well, it didn't start on this campaign. Yes, we can. No. A watchdog gave me this book. It's from 1981. Yes, we can. The book, by the way, look at the top of it, please. Strengthen the Fight Back, Build the Communist Party. The book is from the Communist Party USA. You can package poison to look like candy, but it is still poison. I told you a year and a half ago, please read this book. This is Coming Insurrection, the Invisible Committee. This is written in Europe, and it is written by many of these people who their contacts over in Europe. These are the same people that have written this book, the same kind of people. They're not the literal people, but they have all the same contacts and the same beliefs. And it is the most frightening. In this book, it talks about how you must destroy the family unit. It's evil. And they're communist. They're democratic socialists. Why have I believed that this president is in danger? Look at who he has cobbled together. These people are not fooling around. Read their own words. They're not fooling around. What are you going to say to these people on Saturday? You can pretend for a while, but if you are not a radical socialist, Marxist, communist, somebody who wants a revolution in America, if you are not a radical revolutionary, then you've been leading some of the most dangerous people in our country on the coming insurrection. Our president is in trouble, and if he is not in trouble, if he's, because he's lying to either them or to us. If he's lying to them, he's in trouble. If he's lying to us, we're in trouble. You can call it wishadoo, you can call it ya-ya, you can call it slap, you can call it a big heaping pile of poo-poo, but it's still the same thing. It's communism. It is evil. George Soros has been at this game with these people for a very long time. This is not about the President of the United States. They have been going after our children under our nose for a very long time. Gang, they are this close to winning. This close to winning.